Welcome back. Two vehicles collided yesterday afternoon on Blagg and Mesquite.
Dispatch reported a T-bone type collision at Blagg and Mesquite. Upon arrival, we found a full-size pickup truck had impacted on the side of a small, small four-door sedan. Significant intrusion on that vehicle. However, there was no one on the passenger side, so there were no injuries as a result of that accident.
They all declined to be transported at the time, but Knight County Sheriff's deputies, of course, are investigating the cause of that.
That's correct.
And we caught up with former MMA fighter and co-owner of Green Life Productions, who grows marijuana locally for medicinal purposes.
I'm wearing this protective gear here today because I'm about to go in and join Steve Cantwell with Green Life Productions.
We're a local facility here in Pahrump, founded by a bunch of local Pahrump business owners. This was the former lumber yard of Ace Hardware. We were able to come in here and completely, as you see, revamp the entire inside of the building and turn into what used to be a rusty old lumber yard into a state-of-the-art growing facility.
Utilizing permaculture techniques, which is essentially modeling or simulating the patterns and features observed in natural ecosystems, Green Life Productions' growing method with their no-till living soil is truly organic.
Basically, one way able to use the word organic, we're organic certified, and the only ones currently in Nevada that are organic certified. And what that means is that we basically don't feed our plants any synthetic fertilizers. We don't spray with any pesticides or fungicides, any type of sides whatsoever. We use a unique style of cultivation, which is organic, no-till living soil. And what we do there is we try to break your typical monoculture where you see just one species of plant being grown, and what we try to create is a polyculture where there's diversity of plants being grown to create a biological intelligence within the room themselves and biodiversity within the soil. One of our things that we do is we look to nature for inspiration. Everything we do here is to basically model natural ecosystems and to basically to create like an old growth forest where natural biological systems that have been cycling for and working and evolving for millions of years, we try to model those best in here as possible.
Optimizing the growth potential for maximum yield of the medicinal properties that come from the marijuana flower is a process that requires an understanding of plant reproductive morphology in an environment set by Green Life Productions.
Marijuana is a dioecious plant, meaning it has both male and female. So what we do is, well, first, when we plant seeds, the first thing we do is we single out all the females. The females are the ones who give us the flowers that we look for. Those are the ones with all the cannabinoids and all the medical benefits. So we will discard the males once we identify them. You could do that by simply the pre-flowers. Each one, male and female, throw a different flower. So once you identify what type of flower it's throwing, you can, again, get rid of the males. And then from there, it's basically pheno-hunting through the females. What we do is we look for specific phenotypes that are basically a genetic expression in our environment. So we set the environment and we look for the expression that we like most in our environment. And then from that point, we keep that plant around in a vegetative state and we clone off of that plant.
This is Jason Coleman's reporting for News 46.
We'll have more on this story, including the story behind the lighting and why it has a reddish pink look on next week's segment here on News 46.
The Nevada Division of Public and Behavioral Health has received almost $1 million from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention to reduce prescription drug abuse. This funding comes from Senate Bill 459, which contains several policy changes addressing prescription drug abuse, including mandating prescription monitoring programs, Good Samaritan provisions, and increased use for naloxone. Prescription drug misuse is a severe and growing issue in Nevada. Nevada has the fourth highest drug overdose mortality rate in the United States, with 20.7 per 100,000 people suffering drug overdose fatalities. The number of drug overdose deaths, a majority of which are from prescription drugs, in Nevada increased by 80% since 1999, when the rate was 11.5 per 100,000. The 2013 Nevada Youth Risk Behavior Survey found that 19.4% of high school respondents reported that they have taken prescription drugs without a doctor's prescription. In addition to drug overdose and overdose mortality, Nevada ranks very high in prescribing patterns. Nevada is the second highest for hydrocodone, second highest for oxycodone, fourth highest for methadone, and seventh highest for codeine.
So hopefully that will help. I hope that they get somewhere with that.
Yeah, serious problem, yeah.
News 46 will return in just a moment.